Ambrose and Brent from the band are in studio. Regarding the video real quick, guys, tell me about the concept and what a day of filming is like for you both.
The concept, basically it was just Holy White Hounds going to hell and meeting the devil and seeing a really pretty, pretty devil. Shooting was awesome. I mean, it was a long day, but getting to work with some awesome talent, like our model, like the guy who shot it, Jennifer Case is our model, and Dylan Sires is the guy who shot it. He shot our last one, too. So, I mean, just working with them in general is, you know, a treat, even if you're down there for 13, 14 hours.
I guess if you can't get Dave Grohl to play the devil like you did in The Pick of Destiny with Tenacious D, the next best thing is to find one of the hottest people you know.
That's very right. True. Yeah, and I think we also enjoy, like, the rock and roll cliches. You know, we had Switchblade, we had the rock and roll girl, and then taking it to Satan with our rock and roll music. Yeah, I think that it was just simple and obvious, you know, something fun to do.
Mentioned earlier the Oh Mama EP you put out in October of last year. Since then, you've played some really great shows in front of some big crowds, including some new faces, I imagine, when you opened for, you know, for example, Sick Puppies at Woolies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. And we try to make the most of any of those shows, you know, because they can be spaced out, you know, to where they're few and far between, to where you're not just playing for the fans that would normally come to your show. So when you do get to open for a band like Sick Puppies, we just try to pump up the energy and make sure everybody knows that we're happy that they came out to join. You know?
Absolutely. Now you have plans on playing elsewhere outside of Des Moines, which is pretty exciting too.
Yeah, we're looking at doing some out-of-town gigs as far as kind of mid-spring and late spring, early summer goes. We're working on trying to branch out into Minneapolis a little bit. We've got a couple things set up there. Madison as well. Eventually just trying to do part of like the northern Midwest. We've got some friends in Grand Rapids, but it's 9 hours away to play. You know, even if you get to play for 200 people, that's still 9 hours there and back. So kind of eventually just build a bridge over there and, you know, just kind of keep raising the bar little by little.
I've read that the EP is meant to offer a taste of the music you've been writing recently and that you're planning a full-length release in the near future. That true?
Yeah. Right now, we went in and we recorded 12 songs.
Yeah.
We're going to go back in and do some more, but we just took five ones that were, you know, kind of sampling of what we'd been working on, put those on the EP, and then we got to go back in and do some more, but we're looking at a summer release for the LP.
It's very exciting.
Yeah.
You worked with Brandon Darner, who we know locally from Envy Corps, and he's gained some national cred too now, having worked with Imagine Dragons on their album. How did you become acquainted, and what was it like working with Brandon on this new batch of songs?
Brandon was, he was fantastic to work with, and also we got Micah and Natera engineering it, which is kind of Brandon's sidekick, as I've seen it. That's kind of how
he's like a right-hand man.
Yeah, right-hand man, exactly, yeah. Sidekick would be a slap in the face for what he does.
Well, that would you would think they'd be superheroes at that point, you know
right,
what I mean?
Yeah, well, he is a surgeon,
well,
man.
Are.
Yeah, he can, I mean, he can really just, like, sit there with the takes, and he's quick. So, you know, I think that going into the studio with Brandon was, I just didn't know what to expect at all, so I was just expecting him to make things sound different, you know? And at that point, if you're expecting different, but you don't know what to expect, you know, I guess I'm surprised when I hear some songs, and then when I listen back to the evolution of how, you know, when they start taking tracks away from just us, because we recorded the whole thing live.
Which is really awesome, by
yeah,
the way.
And it just makes, it makes sense, you know?
I don't know, you come in with a skeleton of a song, essentially, an outline. You have maybe a hook, maybe a riff somewhere here and there, but you know, the piecing together comes before you actually record it. So how does that work out, the timing of it?
Most of our songs I will demo out mm-hmm. in my basement before I show them to anyone, or maybe the band will see them and we'll jam on those or whatever, but I think that, well, by the time we got the songs to Brandon, they were pretty much written, and then Brandon will hear things and say things like, hey, this part's really cool, maybe you should do it twice.
Sure.
Or this part's really cool, maybe you should do it once and leave wanting more.
Yeah.
You know, just whatever. He's got the vision of, anytime I've tried to fight Brandon on something I didn't think was a good idea, first of all, he wins. Second of all, it's always the thing that somebody comes up to me and later and says, "Oh, I love what you did with that." And I'm like, "Oh, he got me again."
Brandon.
Yeah.
You're off to a really good start, no doubt about that. You got a big show upcoming this weekend at Gas Lamp. Tell me about that.
It's my birthday that day, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
That was the motivation for
the
show.
Yeah, that's basically just guilting people to come out.
All this video stuff and even, like, the songs we wrote were secondary
to,
like...
Yeah, recording with Brandon Darner is just like, no, Ambrose's birthday on Saturday.
It's all about you, Ambrose.
Yeah.
Take it away, pal.
It's my 26th birthday, so, I don't know, it's going to be a good show. We did one last year, so kind of learned some things from that, but we got... Viva Montessa, they're some friends of ours.
Awesome, yeah, they're great.
And then Red Daughters, they're from Minneapolis. Really, really good. We have our friends, actually some people I went to high school with, in the band Foxholes. They're releasing their album that night.
Nice.
And they're really awesome. They're pretty young, but, I mean, I think they're going to be huge around here. It's my birthday, and we put on, you know, an okay show, so
yeah,
maybe people can
bad.
Give it a shot.
Not too bad. And the Oh Mama EP, if that's any indication, really excited to hear the full length if and when you guys get that out here this year. And look forward to seeing you out at some shows as well. We're all big fans here at the radio station.
Thank you
for allowing us the opportunity to world premiere your video for you.
Yeah, thanks for doing it.
And had a lot of fun. Feel free to stop back anytime.
Yeah. This is not going to be on the radio, correct?
Yeah, man.
All right. Well, but before, like, as we kind of head out, I just was thinking the best thing to do on the radio might be like a funny face contest. Maybe.
Let's do it.
Oh, my God, Ambrose, don't do that. It's going to get stuck.
Every single day I do a funny face contest.
Yeah.
It hasn't panned out the way I wanted it to, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So I stopped setting goals for myself. Ambrose, Brent, Holy White Hounds, thanks again for your time.
Thank you so much.
Time.
Thank you so much.
Time. But this is fun.